We're here in a parking lot of a casino near Phoenix, and I spotted one of these overland expedition vehicles, and I talked to them, and they're willing to give us a tour, and they're Germans, so that makes it actually perfect. So we'll take a look at them. Would you look at that? Germany. Knock, knock. Hi there. Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness, look at the space in here.
You wouldn't believe it from the outside, but there's actually a lot of room in here. Wow.
Okay. Kitchen and living room in the bedroom.
Yeah.
With our dog.
It's very compact, but actually quite roomy. I thought it would be a little bit more tight in here. Hi, Klaus.
More space than you are thinking from outside.
Yeah, exactly. And you even got like a book shelves here. It looks very homey.
Bathroom. You can inside.
Wow, it's gigantic.
Shower?
I did not expect this. Wow. There's a full shower and a separate, so it's not a wet bath. That is impressive. I did not expect that. Yeah, bed looks roomy. And you got your dog there. And lots of storage.
This is for cooking.
Yeah. And you got an oven too. Yeah. Yep. And a nice sink. And a washing machine, of course. There's a closet here. Or pantry. So much storage. And the fridge, yeah.
It's small, it's okay for us.
Yeah. But you got a separate ice compartment and you can freeze stuff, yeah. That's good. And then
the
control panel. Yeah. Wow. Look at that. It's like a spaceship. Is that a coffee maker?
Coffee maker. Yeah, vacuum.
A vacuum. Yeah. Okay. It's wonderful, actually. And it looks very modern and clean. Yep. Oh, and you can open that and climb on the roof from there?
Yes.
From the bed?
Or for fresh air.
Yeah. And look out and enjoy the view. Yeah.
Special windows.
Oh yeah, the dual pane windows and yeah.
Made for mosquitoes and for
Tonight. That's nice. Purpose. And obviously, even if it rains a little bit, you can leave that open.
Yeah,
that's very helpful.
And the glasses are isolated in half.
Yeah, it's dual pane insulated, and so you designed this, right?
Yep.
Okay. So do you wanna tell how you got the idea and how you
Okay, the idea was born if we are traveling a lot of time around the world, and then we like to have our own design. The drawings was done by myself, and the furniture and the cabin was built from a professional company.
Mm-hmm.
And all the technical stuff will plan by myself.
You've got solar on the roof?
We have a lot of solar, we have 1000 watt, and up to now the truck was never on a power plug. All this power we need comes from the solar.
Yeah. When did you build it?
We are finished in 2014. We started in end of 2012 and finished in 2014.
So you bought the truck chassis and that was brand new?
No, it was second hand. Now the chassis, it's now 10 years old.
Uh-huh.
And the cabin, it's built in 2014. And we have all the things we like to have and we need.
So obviously, yeah.
For us, it's okay.
It looks like. So what are all the travels you've been on?
The travels?
Yeah.
Oh, we traveled up to now with the truck 65,000, 70,000 miles.
Mm-hmm.
And we was in complete Europe, we was in Africa, Morocco, and now we arrived in Canada last March, and now we traveled through the Americas, and then we shipped to South America.
Yeah, and you shipped this by boat, right?
We shipped it by boat, yeah.
Wow, that sounds like a crazy logistical nightmare, but it's...
Oh, it's a lot of paperwork.
Yeah.
It's a job, but it's a lot of paperwork.
Yeah. But you always have your house with you,
yeah,
so...
Yeah, it's our exactly. house we have with us, yeah.
Yeah. Cool, and... you said earlier that one of your things was you needed a big sturdy table, yeah. So that's this.
It's very heavy.
The weight of the table is 30 kilograms.
Yeah, oh wow. Okay, that is heavy. Like 60 pounds.
Around 60 pounds.
Yeah. Wow.
It's for
oh
the...
yeah. It's very good organized and it doesn't break when you drive.
It's against shaking to protect the shaking.
Yeah, of course. And also, I mean, this is an expedition vehicle, so you really take it off-road.
We take it off-road, yeah.
It's all-wheel drive.
Four-wheel drive. You can block all the axles. We have 450 horsepower. 5-liter engine.
So block the axles means you can switch off the differentials and...
I have three differentials.
Get the power.
Back and the sender.
Okay. And then you can basically decide, so you're never getting into a situation where you're stuck somewhere and one wheel spins and the other one doesn't move.
Yep.
And all that. Okay, cool. So did you ever get stuck?
Yeah, two times. in the sandy flat, but thanks to our technical equipment, it was not a problem to come out. And you can do it from the
nice
from the
yeah, and you can also like reduce the tire pressure, and
we can also reduce the tire pressure if we go in a sandy area. We lower the pressure and then we can bring it back if we are outside.
Well, do you want to show some stuff on the outside?
Yes, we will do it.
Okay. You can see the dual pane windows there. It's garage. Oh yeah. I did not expect that. You don't often see something like that. So how do you actually get it out and on the ground?
Oh, it's very easy. You can slide out here two bridges.
Uh-huh.
And the four-wheeler have a winch. And with the winch I can pull it out and pull it in. It's a job from 8 to 10 minutes.
Okay.
Now we have a lot of belongings in there.
Yeah. It's like a big spare tire here. Wow.
That's the winch.
Uh-huh.
And here I can put it. And then I push the button and go out or go in.
How high is the vehicle?
12.5 feet.
Okay. Tell us something about the chassis.
The chassis, it's from a German rescue truck.
Rescue truck, okay.
You see here also it has a high clearance here.
Yeah, very high clearance. And those tires are absolutely massive. And on, of course, as with overland vehicles usual, there's only one single rear wheel on each side, because you don't want dualies, because you go overlanding
so fine if you go off-road.
Yeah, because then like something could get in between and rip the tire apart. Okay.
The problem.
Yeah, but obviously this is like heavy duty.
Everything is heavy duty here.
Yeah. So that's why also you didn't buy this truck brand new. It would probably be cost prohibitive then.
Not only the cost, the technique. This truck I can drive also in South America with diesel. The quality is not so
fine. Oh yeah, right.
If I have a newer truck, I have a problem with the filters and everything.
Yeah. So you got a lot of fuel and tanks for water and all that stuff?
We have 200 gallons diesel. And the mileage is around about 10, between 9 and 11 miles per gallon.
So yeah, 10.
And fresh water we have 180 gallons.
That's a lot, wow.
That's more than enough, yeah. And the truck is designed that we can stay outside, out of civilization for 3 weeks without any problems.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. Let's take another look here. man truck. That is quite some cockpit, and you really have to climb in there. So you stay fit just by climbing in and out.
Yeah. And we have another feature.
Oh, nice.
The outside cooking station.
Outside grill and
cooking outside.
Yeah.
Also grill itself.
Yeah. Wow.
So we are equipped for all weather conditions.
Uh-huh. So you got one big spare tire there. Have you learned how to replace it yourself?
Yeah, sure. If we are outside and we have flat tire, nobody's there which can assist us.
Yeah. And these are like toolboxes?
It's a storage.
Storage of
spare
parts.
We like can lower down with a crane, with a small crane.
Oh, okay. Yeah. And getting on the roof, you do it from the inside?
No, from inside or from outside. We have a ladder.
Okay.
The chassis, and we can go up with the ladder.
Yeah. And you got a big antenna up there. That's for Wi-Fi?
That's for Wi-Fi.
Yeah. Very, very cool. Some essential outdoor gear here too. Okay, well, thank you so much, Klaus.
Thank you, welcome.
And I hope to keep in touch with you.
We'll be sure.
And thank you.